In this episode, we climb a mountain, Antoine flies his drone, and a girl eats a sandwich.
And welcome to day 4 of Lofoten Islands. So, we just parked up and gonna be doing a bit of exploring. Basically, we're just driving along the road and came past this parking lot with a lot of cars on it. So, kind of just awoken our interest and we thought, if all these people parked up here, there must clearly be something interesting going on. So we just got out the car and decided to explore a bit. So, got the camera gear, got my tripod, and just gonna see if we can find some compositions. Seeing some beautiful mountains up ahead, so I think that's a good start, and let's see if we can make this happen. All the hype was definitely not unfounded. Look at the scenery, it's insane. Got the lake here and the mountains, it's just breathtaking. So all the hikers that were on the parking lot, they've actually run up a trail here up on the side. And we just stayed here, set up our tripods and busted out the wide angles and are just getting as many clouds and mountains in as possible. Lake, of course, as well, but it looks insane. Antoine shot his drone up in the air, got some amazing footage.
It looks sick, honestly, so fucking good.
Yeah, great footage from up in the air. Hope to include that as well, but yeah, check out this view behind me. A little bit about the setup we're using today. I'm using my 18mm wide angle lens, which is a prime lens, my Zeiss. And attached to the front, I've got a filter holder with a soft grad and 10 stop filter inside. Reason being why I chose those two filters is the 10 stop filter allowed for exposure times of up to 2 minutes, which allowed me to track a bit of cloud movement in the sky, get the water silky smooth. And then the soft grad just helped a lot because you can see that the sky is a lot brighter in the foreground, and by using a soft graduated filter, you're adding a bit of darkness, a little bit like sunglasses, to the top of the sky. And then with the mountains and stuff, you need a bit of a soft blend just to bring it into the foreground, and that's why this little piece of glass comes in really useful to balance the scene. So what that looks like as the final result, I'll show you in a second. Here it is. Decided to attempt the hike afterwards. It's super steep, extremely muddy and slippery, and we still got a long way to go, but so far it's worth it. Look at this incredible view behind us, and it's only going to get better at the top. Let's go, keep moving. This is by far the most grueling hike I've ever done in my entire life, but the views are worth it. Didn't feel like that on the way up, I was dying. Feel incredibly unfit, but I guess you're better for it afterwards. And gotta keep pushing. Final stretch ahead. Let's make this happen. Oh, by the way, down here, back there, is where we parked. So just to give you a sense of scale of how crazy steep this is, and how far we've come already. Final push, tripod and camera out, and hope we can get some winners. Let's go. caught up with Antoine, who's probably been here for about 45 minutes already, because he's slightly fitter than I am. But yeah, at least that gives me the opportunity to ask him for advice, what all the best angles are, what all the best camera settings is, and I guess the work's made easy for me. Nah, just kidding. So yeah, obviously, do want to capture this moment, get the camera out. Been lugging all these kilograms up the whole mountain, so let's make that count. And I'll check in with you guys in a second with some hopefully good photos. So that's a wrap from the top of this mountain. Doesn't really need much commentary, views speak for itself, and really, really happy with the photos we got. Now it's time to strip out of these warm clothes, which feels really counterintuitive because it's freezing cold up here, get back in the t-shirt and start the hike down. So check in with you guys at the bottom, because I'm gonna need my hands for this one. A lot of rocks, a lot of hand holding, and I'm pretty scared that I might fall. It's really slippery and muddy. Anyway, see you later. So on the way down from the mountain, my battery died and I had to stop vlogging, but that's all charged up and we're back in action. So in the meantime, we drove back to the football field where we were in my previous vlog. And the reason we decided to come back is because back then the weather was really poor, it was raining hard, and the backdrop was completely washed out. But now we're in a lot better luck because, check this out. The sky's just looking incredible, got this crazy pattern and layers and texture in the clouds, which looks amazing. And then also, when we're done flying the drone, capturing this football field here, we're gonna probably try reshoot this lighthouse or these houses up here again with the cliffs, because same problem the other day where weather was so poor and sky was completely white out, and just wasn't a great photo in the end. So with this sky texture and the foreground, is just gonna look pretty good, I think. So definitely gonna give that a go as well. Cameras, so perfect setting. Gonna try to get these shots, but before we do that, gonna tell you about the craziest thing that just happened. Antoine over here, still giggling away, and almost falling over. Got asked by these Asian guys, well, that doesn't matter, but got asked by these guys to help him out with their drone because they had no clue how to use it. The guy's like extremely grateful that Antoine set it up for him, and the thing shoots off straight out to ocean. Error, warning. Game over, and the drone just starts hovering over the ocean and it's almost in into the abyss. But then last second rescue by the hero over here, grabbed it into manual mode, brought it back home, and smiling faces on certain people. But I'm pretty confident that in the next two hours or so, that thing's definitely gonna be photographing the fish in the sea, not the skies. So that happened, but now back to business, photography matters. Here's our composition, beautiful buildings back here, sky is looking lush. And we're gonna try get our wide angles out and let's make this happen. I absolutely love the ruggedness of this coastline, and all these ridges work as perfect leading lines that lead you up to the house. And the backdrop of the sky is absolutely incredible as well. Another thing I always like to keep an eye out for in my shots is a bit of water. And I asked myself the question, how can I make the water look the most dramatic? And the way I've done that is by introducing a 6-stop filter to my wide-angle lens. And the wide-angle lens, of course, captures everything I just explained. What the 6-stop filter allows you to do is to get shutter speeds up to 15 seconds, where you can get the water extremely flat, or with a wider aperture, which lets in more light, of course, you can work with a bit faster shutter speed. It's up to 2 seconds, and depending on what works for you and what looks best, you get very different effects in the water. So 15 seconds will give you smooth water, and 2 seconds will give you choppy waves that look very dramatic. So yeah, that's kind of what I was experimenting around with, getting the shutter speed just right, just to bring out the drama of a shot. And do check it out. Here's the final result. Dear Lighthouse, that's a wrap. So, really chuffed with those photos. A lot of drama and a great composition all around as well. So, really good spot, highly recommend it. And actually driving into this town, there's one more composition that we spotted just from the side of a car. So we were driving over a bridge and the harbour was just on our left side and looks stunning, fishing boats, Norwegian buildings, you know the drill. Beautiful backdrop with some mountains. And yeah, before we leave the town, we're definitely gonna have a quick pit stop there, get out the camera again and see if we can capture that on the way out. So let's hop in the car and make that happen. I hope I didn't promise too much, but me personally, I'm loving this composition. Got the harbour here, and each side of the harbour, with the boats on the sides, makes for some beautiful leading lines that lead up to that cloud-covered mountain in the back. So that's really cool, really feeling that vibe. And let's talk about shooting technique. So what I really wanted to achieve is make the reflections in this harbour as pure as possible. So first thing that sprang to mind was this haziness on the water. So I used a circular polarizer to cut that out. And the second thing I wanted to achieve is to remove these ripples to make the water really smooth and make the reflections of these boats more pronounced. And for that I had to use a neutral density filter. So popped in my 6-stop filter for that one. And I was playing around with the shutter speed. So I realized with shutter speeds of up to 30 seconds, I got some beautiful cloud movement, but the boats also do move a bit in the water, so they were slightly blurry and I didn't like that. So tinkered around with the shutter speed and the aperture a bit, and finally managed to get a 4-second shutter speed, and with that the boats were proper sharp and the water was nice and smooth, and I'm really happy with the shot. So let's go check it out. ISO 100 6-stop filter f5.6 4 seconds. Here it is. So we're back on the road, and today was actually our last full day in Lofoten, so still got a long road trip ahead of us before we get to the hotel. So no more shooting today, but I thought it'd be perfect time to end this vlog, and hope you enjoyed this little mini series of Antoine and I discovering Lofoten Islands. And we had a great time shooting it anyway, so for what it's worth. And anyway, I think it's time to end this vlog, so thank you for watching. Hope you enjoyed it, and if you did, be sure to like and comment, and if you aren't already, I'd love it if you'd subscribe. See you in the next episode, which is probably going to be a London one. See you then.